search and rescue technicians dove into their exercises on September 25th as they brushed up their scuba skills in Cold Lake. The divers, based out of Four Wing Cold Lake, are members of 417 Combat Support Squadron. Sergeant Glenn Hood has been doing this for 12 years. The equipment is similar to that used by regular divers. From the Zodiac boat, to the oxygen tank, to the dry suit he's wearing. The dry suit uses watertight seals to keep the water out and the warmth in. If he needs a little more insulation in deep water, Hood can fill his suit with air.
If I let it go for a while, it kind of looks like the Michelin Man.
Search and rescue team isn't just about diving.
Primarily, we're paramedics. And then we have to be able to access sites by in different means. So diving is one of them, parachuting is another, being able to use the helicopter and hoisting. We need to actually be able to work through mountain rescue systems and technical rope rescue systems as well.
And when he needs to get somewhere fast, he relies on helicopter pilots like 27-year-old Captain Nicole Lively. She's only on her first flying tour with the squadron, but she has already been a part of some major missions.
Calgary floods last spring. We went down to High River and evacuated 9 people and delivered 2 doctors to the hospital.
If you can hear me, it's search and rescue. We're coming to get you.
The search and rescue unit just came back from Goose Bay, Newfoundland, where they, along with personnel from across the country, participated in land, air, and water search and rescue exercises. The exercises are a part of an annual event involving troops from across the country. Today, though, in Cold Lake, the troops are focused on brushing up on their skills underwater. They have to dive once every 90 days to stay current. Hopefully, that's the only reason this search and rescue team will ever have to get its feet wet. For the Cold Lake Sun, I'm Peter Lozinski.